Today, the glory of ancient Egypt is ruins and dust. And this greatest of the Earth's early civilizations, a thing of darkness and mystery. These mighty monuments tell us of a people who were rulers of the world, who created a civilization never surpassed for beauty and splendor. But the Egyptians were not only builders of monuments, they were human beings no different from ourselves. This is the story of a man who dwelt in the ancient land of the Nile 33 centuries ago.
Sinhue the Egyptian, write this. In my place of exile on the shores of the Red Sea, there is no more desolate spot on earth. Soon the jackals and the vultures will make a poor meal of what is left of me. No monument will mark my resting place. I will leave only this, the story of my life. I have lived fully and deeply. I have tasted passion, crime, and even murder. It is for you to judge me. You must weigh the good against the evil, the passion against the tenderness, the crime against the charity, the pleasure against the pain. I began life as I am ending it, alone.
I rode alone on the bosom of the Nile, in a boat of reeds daubed with pitch and tied with fowler's knots. Thus the city of Thebes was accustomed to dispose of its unwanted children. I grew up on the waterfront of the city, in the house of my foster parents, who had saved me from the river. My foster father lived there by choice, because he was, also by choice, physician to the poor of the city.
From the rich he could have commanded princely fees, for he alone in Thebes was master of the ancient art of opening skulls.
Wine ready. Afraid, Sinhue? Good. You must never fear death. In our craft, death is a familiar companion. This time, we'll cheat him. Look, this tiny splinter of bone pressing on the brain. When I remove it, he will speak again, and walk, and live.
Why, Father? Why?
No one knows.
From the beginning, I kept to myself. I used to wander alone on the banks of the Nile until the day came when I was ready to enter the school of life. In the school of life were trained the chosen young men of Egypt,
her future scientists and philosophers, statesmen and generals. All the learning of Egypt lay in the keeping of the gods. For 10 years, I served them in the school, that I might earn the right to call myself a physician. I learned to bend my body to them, but that was all. My mind still asked a question.
Why? Sinhue, be careful, the priest.
Of our classmate Horemheb, the best swordsman, the finest horseman, the fastest runner, and the strongest wrestler.
And the first one to tell about it.
Well, if you don't speak well of yourself, no one will do it for you. This I learned from the god. You've drunk to what I am. Now drink to what I will be. Well, the day will come when I will carry the golden whip and lead you all into battle. Hey, you're not drinking, my friend. Wine.
He's had enough.
Never enough for a friend.
He'll finish the night in some gutter with his throat cut.
He's under my protection. To your future.
Future!
Look at our brilliant physician.
See, I'm a student.
He's got the real exact.
Can I help you?
Just a thing. Don't throw things at my friend. He's a stubborn, arrogant fool, but he's my best friend.
Then take him home.
The tavern wench can't give orders to the son of the falcon.
The son of a cheesemaker. Take him home. Good night, physician. Your friend is the fool, not you.
Why is it no one will ever answer me when I ask why?
Come on, let's go.
How did she know your father was a cheesemaker?